I never met a girl who makes me feel the way that you do. You're all right. Whenever I mess to make my dreams real, I see that you do. You're out of sight. So feed my full fun. Look out, look baby, out, oh, cause here I come. If you wanna play hide and seek, well, love, let me remind you,
it's alright.
Cause loving you gonna mess up the time it takes to find you,
it's out of sight.
So twiddly-dee, twiddly-doo, look out, baby, cause here I go. Oh, my friend should want you to understand it.
Be alright.
I hope I get to you before they do the way I planned it.
Be out of sight.
Look out, look baby, out, cause here I come. I'm bringing your love, it's true. So get ready, get ready. Gonna try to make your love to do. So get ready, so get ready, cause here I come.
Get ready, cause here I come.
I'm on my way.
Get ready, cause here I come.
Here I come.
Thank you. This is a song I wrote just recently. It's called I Love You.
When I see you, I feel so good. I would be with you always if I could. I had always wanted to let you know, but I could not find the nerve to tell you so, that I love you. Such a thrill to spend time together, you know I will. Last night we had so much fun. When it comes to love, girl, you're the one. Cause I love you.
I love you, you, oh, I love you, you, only you. I love you, you, only you.
When I see you, I feel so good. I would be with you always if I could.
Good afternoon, I'm Marva Richardson, and that was some kind of song.
Oh,
let me tell you something, if you weren't in love, you'll be in love. That was what you call mellow, to the heart. And Ms. Lynch, you know you always hit me to the heart.
Oh, thank you.
Today we're going to have the honors of having Mr. Lance Bruce with us. And I got your name wrong last week. I said Bruce Lance, but I was excited.
But you always call me that. You
I know.
Call me every
But listen, and sir, give us your name, and we're going to be talking with, you know,
Kenny McAllister.
Yeah, we're going to let them talk and do their own interaction. But first of all, I want to get me out of the way. I want to say that this particular program is for LAPA.
Okay.
And we were supposed to do a very special thing for LAPA today, but we had to postpone that because of one of the people that were to do it for us. That's going to come at a later date. But this still is for LAPA, the people that keep us on, have kept us on, live access TV.
Okay.
And for their diligence and their hard work and their love and all the things that they brought to the table, this is how we come on and do what we do.
That's
Isn't
nice.
That a good thing?
That's a really good thing, yes.
Yes, so again, we're going to be talking about the LAPA dance, but I have someone I want to quickly and get me out of the way. As I said, I have a sister of mine that she tricked me. Boy, that was a trick because I thought to call you, but I said she's not going to come on. So this is my sister Toni, and Toni will introduce herself, but I want to talk about next Sunday we'll be back on again, sir, but
okay.
That will be with Evangelist Willa Ford, and
oh,
she's going to
okay.
be doing my half hour, and then she's going to be running into her half hour,
okay.
which is going to be Soul Food and Living Waters.
She
and
is great. I love her.
Isn't she something?
Yeah, she's fantastic.
When she puts the word to you, you got it.
Yeah.
I mean, you
Amen.
Feel the word.
Amen.
And then the following Sunday, like, we'll kind of probably be rotating, because I'm leaving that half hour open for people that have desires. prison ministries, a lot of different things, but Ms. Evangelist Ford will be on quite often on From the Heart. Also, I wanted to say to you that the thing, and I want this to be known, no, I did not get rid of Josie Roy, and I'm getting teary-eyed. Josie is not with us any longer, but it's not a bad thing. Josie was like a mother, you know how a mother bird kind of gets her, you know, when they first are born, the birds, and then the mother kind of throws you off their wing, yes. Kind of like that. She just kind of, you know, she left me on my own.
But to be honest about it, Marva, she's been working on it, reviving this church Old Newcastle. And she's been working on this project so diligently.
And I got that down
she's had very, very little time to kind of do
here.
A lot of
now,
TV
Salem
shows.
Church is right around the corner from us. And I wanted to say, too, in behalf of Josie was, she's wonderful. She's got her own. She's got a program called Out and About. She works with Executive Tom Gordon. Okay. She's got the Lapa Hour. And, you know, and if anybody wants to know why, you know, she lived, of course I do know why. Mm-hmm. I have kind of like what you, Tony, like a kind of discernment of spirit. I know, but it's a good thing.
Yeah.
And, you know, and I know wherever she's at, Josie's about doing a good thing.
Amen.
And whenever she wants me to do anything and support her and read something or, hey, I don't have a problem with that. She's still a part of us.
Marva, if Josie tells you she's going to do something, she does,
she does
it. She will do it.
Yeah.
You know, it will get done.
You better believe it. So I just want to let you know, even though she's not a part of us now, she's on doing her own things, but she's been wonderful. I'm going to surprise her. We're going to be doing a little bit of political version before the big, you know, they're in the politics now on TV.
Okay.
And I'm going to do my own thing. I've been listening and learning and doing this and doing that, and I will probably have some candidates on. But when the biggie comes, of course, you know, that'll be months from now, but I'm still going to do a mini version.
Okay.
So I just want to, but I learned that. I learned a lot from Josie Roy, and I want to thank her for just being my big sister, my confidant, you know, my supporter, and being all the good things. And I thank her for letting throwing off all those things off on me.
Okay.
So I got to do good. I got to be proud of me. So Josie, we love you. We love the 9 years you spent with From the Heart, and we're still here, even though she's not here in spirit. Mm-hmm. She is in spirit, but she's about doing her
other things. Okay.
So now, and with that being said, and then Mount Salem, we don't want to forget, I think it's, Mr. Bruce, can you talk about that? And then I'm going to let you talk to this gentleman and talk to my sister.
Well, it's on the 12th, September the 12th. Mm-hmm. The time, I'm not really that sure about. All I know is Josie called me and asked if I would, you know, perform or I would sing.
Yes.
So I think they had me singing the Star Spangled Banner and the Lord's Prayer and Lift Every Voice. So those three songs I'll be doing. It's a kind of commemoration and revitalization.
Yes.
They're trying to restore the church. It has a large historical value in the old Newcastle area. And so Josie's been working on this ever since day one when they realized that they wanted to do something to preserve the church. She has a personal interest because she has family members buried in the cemetery behind the church.
And Mr. Lance,
her father, her grandparents, and
Josie,
uncles.
I'm married to Josie's cousin, so it's
The Roy's,
you know,
there.
And we live on, my mother still lives on Newcastle on Delaware Street, directly off from the library.
Mm-hmm.
So we live right around the corner from Mount Salem. So we've been very close to Bethany and Mount Salem. So, you know, we're going to do all we can to support this.
Yeah.
So you just continue to, you know, talk on it, support it, whatever we can do.
Well, she called me last week and asked if I would, you know, perform. And I usually don't say no to Josie when she asks me to do anything. You know.
Yeah. But listen, while you're going, we want to continue. I want you to bring your gentleman on, and then we're going to work on her a bit. And then we want to, because this time goes by so fast.
Yeah, yeah.
So,
well, Kenny McAllister is an old school buddy of mine from way back.
Not that old.
Well, we you don't want to get into the age thing.
Okay.
But he was one of the original members of a band called the Four Souls. And they were one in the mid-60s, late-60s, early-70s. They were one of the hottest bands in the Wilmington area as far as playing R&B, funk, soul. Whatever you want to call it, they could do it. Hip hop wasn't around then when the kids, so we wouldn't say hip hop, but if they were still together today, they probably could hang with hip hop too as well. But they were so versatile. My group, my original high school group, the Majestics, The Four Souls used to back us up at a lot of our concerts
in
the Wilmington area, especially when we did P.S. DuPont or Walnut Street Y or Longshoreman, places like that. Salesianum, we did some shows there. And they were so good that they really complimented anything that we did. You know, in those days, I was doing pretty much what I'm doing now, you know, singing songs like some of the old Motown songs like Get Ready and Ooh Baby Baby. And they would back us, and they really were a fantastic band to work with. Well, see, I enjoyed working with those guys, you know.
Lance's group reminded me of the Temptations because they performed those type of songs, and they had the look, except they had a female in the front.
Valerie Tillman.
And when they performed, they just looked just like the Temptations.
Because we were all tall, skinny, and lean, and we had the voices, you know. We could pretty much... And you can still hear some of it, some of the Temptation sound in a lot of the songs that I sing, you know, a lot of the music. I kind of emulated everything that Eddie and Dave and those guys did back in the day. And because I grew up on them, you know, from age 13 to 14 up till 20, 21 years old, I would, everything they were, every song they were writing and producing and releasing, I was sucking in, you know. So by the time I graduated from high school, I knew almost every song that came out of Motown, you know, male and female, you know, I was blessed with the voice that I could sing bass and first tenor. So whatever group whoever was singing lead in my group, I would take their place in the background. So if one person was singing bass, I would be singing bass in the background. If someone else was singing tenor, first tenor, I'd be singing first tenor in the background, and it really helped to balance out our group. Kind of like Otis of the Temps, that was his role. You know, whoever sang lead in the Temptations, and he very seldom sang lead, but his voice was so that he could blend in, he could fill in the harmony parts with his voice, you know, because he sang first tenor, second tenor, baritone, and bass, you know, just like me. And that's unique to be able to do that, to have that range where you can sing with the girls and then sing at the bottom too, you know. So
well, the only thing he really did was Old Man River as a lead singer.
Yeah, well, Melvin, that was Melvin, the bass singer.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, sir, I understand you play the keyboard.
Yes.
Where's it at?
I didn't bring it.
Now you've got to come and bring that keyboard.
But in the days when he was with the Four Souls, he was the sax player, wasn't he? And he could play the sax. He was really a great sax player. He was a great keyboard player. Matter of fact, on that love song that I did earlier, he played keyboards on that.
Thanks, Lance.
And that is the first time that we collaborated since 1968.
Yeah,
that's the first time we've been together since 1968.
We don't play age here, sir. We just live.
Now, you told me not to call you ma'am, so please don't call me sir.
Well, sir, you know what? Let me say something to you. We were raised to say sir and ma'am.
Yeah,
it has nothing to do with age. It's just a matter of respect. And, you know, you better say thank you. You better be grateful. That's what we were taught. And I know I'm older than you, sir, but it's just me respecting you as we were raised.
Okay.
Josie can tell you that.
Okay.
Back in the day. And you know what? I love the Roy family because her mother was like my mother, Miss Gloria Roy.
Yeah.
And, you know, they taught each other.
Mm-hmm.
They were family. They were parents to her parents. It was my parent. And it was just, I could always go to Miss Roy's house. And I get kind of emotional because as I was going through things, so I would run through the streets.
Okay.
Josie's family didn't live too far from me, and talked to Mrs. Roy.
Uh-huh.
And she always took the time to be concerned and to, you know, do what she could to help us. And she made me feel real special. Mm-hmm. So I still got the Roy family, you know, Josie, and then Mary. I just loved the Roy family.
Okay.
So
okay.
I just wanted to let you. But listen, I could go on and on. But I want you, this young lady right here sitting up there trying to think she's not Mr. Lance.
Yeah, we know her. We know her.
Go ahead now. Don't be bashful.
Well, the guys are bragging about the male group.
Yeah, yeah.
But I sang with a group called the Uteeks.
Oh, yeah.
And we were hot.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, we were good. It was five girls.
In more ways than one.
Beautiful,
It was Ernestine Betts, Rita Hurt, Aline Marshall, Mamie Boehner, and myself. And we had a group called the Uteeks, and we had a band, the Dynamic Concepts. And we were a little hot pants and upset, you know, the audience a lot.
Mm-hmm.
And we used to sing in the Rodney Square quite often, you know, and actually we could have gone could have gone far, but you know, some of us decided to go to college and do something else with our lives. So, but hopefully we're going to be doing a little bit more again.
Yeah, I'm glad
the fact that you guys have decided and stuff to bring the old groups back. Yeah. I think it's something definitely we need to do in Wilmington, because there's a lot of talent in Wilmington.
Yeah.
And when we encourage ourselves, we're also encouraging our kids in the community.
Amen.
You know, to get involved and do things.
Amen.
And hopefully more groups will be formed, you know, because of us.
Yeah.
To bring it all back.
And it's been fun, even though I've never got an opportunity. When I sang with the Majestics and when I sang with Wish, we never got an opportunity to perform with the Utiques, you know, because I guess different times, you know. I think we were in the military when the Utiques were kind of doing their thing here in Wilmington. And that's what broke the Majestics up. We all went into the military during the Vietnam War. We all volunteered to go in and decided we got, you know, take care of that responsibility first. And then we'll deal with, you know, if we made it back home, okay, then we would deal with our music.
Yeah.
If we still had the voices and the bodies and everything.
Yeah.
But when we got back home, only two of us decided to, you know, move on. That was me and the late LaRue Tillman. We decided to move forward. But to get too far away from the purpose of us being here, we're part of an organization called the R&B, R&B, Soul, Funk.
Wilmington Old School. R&B, soul, and funk entertainers.
Entertainers, yeah. It's a collaboration of groups and singers and musicians from the 60s, 70s, and 80s coming back together to help define what we did back then, as well as what we're trying to do now. And as Tony was saying about introducing the young people to our music and what we were capable of doing, how our sounds and our performances and who we were and who those groups were, because a lot of people never heard of the Utiques in Wilmington or the Majestics or Wish, you know, or the Matadors or the Dynamic Concepts.
Or the Four Souls.
Or the Four Souls, exactly. And these were all great musicians and great performers, you know. Many of them had records, some didn't, but all were great performers, you know, as far as putting on a show, they could really entertain.
Now, yes, that was one aspect of it. Now, the idea came from a guy named Keith Smith.
Keith Smith, another member of the Four Souls. Mm-hmm.
He played guitar. He came up with this idea of bringing the musicians together back in the 60s and 70s to do what's going to be the Funk Fest on September 5th. But he asked me to read this,
yes,
if
sir,
I can.
Please.
Let me take my glasses off because I can't read with my glasses on. this is Keith Smith's words now. It was great to hear R&B, soul, and funk music in the city again, especially at Rodney Square. Our city has a rich history of this type of music. About 50 years ago, if you danced and partied at your high school or at the Jewish Y or the neighborhood community centers, you partied to one of our local bands and singers.
Right.
Then, when you got older, you partied at the Longshoremen, Steelworkers Hall, that was in Claymont, the Elks Home, that was on 11th Street, Odd Fellows Hall, that's on 34th and Market, and the Armory. Local groups like the Four Souls, the Mellow Souls, the Soul Sextet, the Utiques, Skip Butler, Wish, the Overtones, the Naz Band, which Keith was a member of, Pat Noel, a.k.a. Dr. Nyla Gilliam, and the Dynamic Concepts. Well, the historic organization, Wilmington Old School R&B, Soul, Funk Entertainers, will bring this history to you. That's our purpose, one of our purposes. We have two reasons to be, is to educate the city of Wilmington about these groups that were back in the 60s and the 70s.
Right.
Because they contributed a lot to people's memories at that time. And up to this day, they did. Our mission is to bring books, documentaries, and media presentations describing the history and to work to have the R&B Sound Festival here in the city of Wilmington. We'd like to have we have a Clifford Brown Festival. We have a
Bob Marley
Festival. Mm-hmm. we'd like to have a R&B festival in the same manner. Many of these entertainers went on to be international stars like the late James Ajax Baynard and Ajax, Skip Butler with the Crown House Affair. Skip will be performing at the Funk Fest 2015, the event on September 5th at the Longshoreman, 200 South Claymont Street, from 9 p.m. to 1 p.m., along with the original Four Souls and Durations. That was another vocal group.
Right.
So get your tickets, and we'll see you at the Funk Fest.
You know, I'm kind of excited because, Mr. Lance, I did not know that you, it's a small world, and this one right here, and you two.
We actually went to school together.
I just found that out.
Well,
recently.
They went to Wilmington High School. I went to Howard.
No, actually, I was at PS, but I'm talking earlier. We went to Stubbs together.
Oh, Stubbs. Okay.
And I'm not sure, were you at Bancroft too?
No, I went to Warner.
Warner, okay.
I was at Bancroft.
Well, I went to Warner my last year because my family had moved.
Yes. But listen, while we're on this now, Tony, I know, you know, I do things. Don't pay me no mind now.
Okay.
I roll from the heart.
Okay.
Now, Tony, the time does go by fast, and Mr. Lance is going to give us a song or two before we close out. But, Tony, would you like to, I'm going to give you a few minutes to say what you're into, and then before you do anything, can you give us just a touch of a note?
Okay.
Be obedient.
Well, I'm just going to tell a personal story. Recently, I retired myself from working in the school district. I didn't know at the time why I was being moved, but sometimes God does things in his own way. And as most people know me, they know that I write poetry, and I've been writing poetry for years. Written over approximately maybe around 3,000 poems.
Wow.
And I'm proud to say, and I know my aunt's gonna get me, but that I'm in the midst of publishing my book. It's gonna be called Simply Beautiful. And I'm actually laying it out now, and it'll be coming out hopefully for the end of the year. I'm very, very excited about it. And hopefully also, I've been talking with Lance and also Kenny, that some of, you know, my love poems will be able to put to music,
The
love song that you just sang is beautiful.
Mm-hmm. Thank you.
And so I said, sometimes we don't know why God moves us, you know, it's not up to us to question him. You know, and I'm happy where I am right now in my life. I also have a little CD of my own that I recorded 18 poems on, and I've been selling them, and believe it or not, people really they've been enjoying my poetry. So I'd like to share a couple of my poems with you, if I can.
That sounds good.
And I'm going to start with reciting one called, We Always Start With God, and it's called
Amen.
If You're Looking For Me. If you're looking for me, I will be the wave of the ocean, the sea shifting in motion, the morning dew wetting the grass, a horn blown made of brass, the clouds drifting in the sky, a bird ready to fly, a song before it's sung, a picture painted to be hung, a cry of babies, a turtle walking lazily, the innocence of a lamb, the taste of hot steamed clams, the sound of thunder before the rain, the clouds watching you from a plane, a tick of your heart, a light of a candle spark, the thought of a book before it's read, a word spoken before it's said, I am love, I am life, I am the Lord, I am Christ. If you're
Amen.
Looking for me, I'm everywhere.
Hmm.
And
Amen.
It was so funny today when
That's
I went
beautiful.
To church. Thank
yeah.
you. I told the pastor, I said, you know, he said, if you're looking for God, he's everywhere. I said, how did you know that's titled one of my poems? And so that's a religious poem, but you want me to go on and recite a love poem?
Yes. That's right in tune with his song.
Okay, this one's called Peeking at Me. I think you're peeking at me, who I am. I think you're starting to notice things about me that I've never allowed others to see. You're seeing me like a hidden ship stretching itself out to sea. I'm beginning to see how much you care about me. Others have tried to find out who I really am, but never took the time to visit me inside. You started from the first time you arrived. How is it that you've been peeking at me? It's a fine feeling when someone has taken the time to see you as you are. It's like taking a glimpse at the shooting stars. It's a nice feeling when you find a delightful friend, someone who tells you, I'll never leave you, I'm hanging with you to the end. One who takes the time to bring you flowers and cards. One who takes the time to listen to all that you have to express, never judging or caring any less. One who shows you that they'll be with you regardless of your emotions, whether you're happy, sad, or feeling glad. Now that you've peeked at me, you look deeply into my eyes, and nothing I say captures you by surprise. You see me as a multitude of personalities, each different but loving in a special way. You see me for the sunshine that stays even when there's a cloudy day. Obviously, you have been peeking at me. There's a place I know in your heart when I'm around that sets off a spark. You boast about me in the strangest places, allowing me to feel so special and divine. I'm inclined to think you're falling in love with me, but I think it's because you've been peeking at me.
Oh, that's beautiful.
Well, y'all are getting sentimental now.
Yeah.
That's one, and I've been on you. You know, sir, I'm always on her. You know, it is time.
But Marva, you see the kind of talent that we have in Wilmington, yes, and so much focus. As I travel around the world, because I really consider myself an international recording artist because I've sold more records in Europe, Japan, and Germany than I have in Wilmington, you know. The caliber of talent that we have in the city of Wilmington is really phenomenal. But all the focus, whenever I'm around the world, people want to talk about the shootings and the murders and and we should be discussing those issues because they're critical to the times that we're living in. But by the same token, the talent that we have here really needs to be developed and defined to a point where we can really give homage to those people that are really doing a great job, who have done a great job of as performers and entertainers and poets in our community. Because it's one of the reasons why kids don't have hope in our community is because they have so much negativity going on. And they don't hear about all the positive things that are going on, and they don't get to hear from the great talent that we have in our community.
Speaking of talent in our community,
it is.
On September 5th, at the Longshoreman, 200 South Claymont Street in Wilmington, from 9 to 1, it's going to be a Funk Fest event. Now, what a Funk Fest is people like us, musicians and vocalists, getting together to just have fun, have a jam session in front of the local people here in Wilmington. I know Lance gets it, Tony probably does too, where they look at you and say, hi, Kenny. Second thing they ask is, are you still playing?
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Yep.
So we like to present this to answer that question.
Yes. That's so beautiful. You know, I wanted to say, Tony, I don't want to go into a lot of this. I want you to sing a few bars, and I want to give Mr. Lance time to get himself over to that mic again to give us a few songs, and we like final thoughts. Mm-hmm. But Tony, I wanted you to just remember David, our cousin. He was supposed to be here, and David, who's is international too. And you know, he's getting on the boat Friday.
Yeah.
I wish he wouldn't go on the boat, but he travels all over, sir, to bring. And just, you know, remember, Tony, I met through Cynthia Tyre. Well, I met David, who's through Tony, Small World.
You know, I caught him on TV on at one of the parades. I can't remember whether it was Christmas or New Year's in Philadelphia. He was marching with the Indian Nation.
Yes.
He's one of their chiefs, and he was marching with them. And I said, I was telling my family, I said, you know, I was on the Marva show with him. I think it was a Christmas special that we did together. And he performed and I performed. And that was the first time I got to meet him. But I got to see him. He was with the Indian Nation at the I think it was New Year's Day parade or one Thanksgiving Day parade. Right. I can't remember which one it was. A couple of years ago on Channel 6.
And but he wanted to be here so bad today.
Yeah.
But, sir, he's going on the boat Friday, and he's got so many things to tie up. And, you know, so I wanted everyone to remember him. He will be coming back in 6 months. And, Tony, thank you for allowing me to meet. You know, I'm just meeting a lot of people that I didn't know that were related to me. And it's really been an honor.
Well, you come from a very, very talented family.
Yes. Amen.
And you know, because Lance, you know my grandparents.
Yeah.
And everybody, and even the small ones right now, it's amazing.
Right.
You know, but that's one thing that our family strives on. We're really working with our children and our family to do the right things.
And that's important.
Yeah.
I just wish the community would look at the talents of the kids. I wish that the schools would make sure that we continue to keep the arts in the school, because our kids gravitate towards those things, and it's so important. Yeah.
Let me ask you a question now. You have this event September 5th.
Yes.
I can't think on the calendar. Is there a first Sunday that I'm on? Because I was going to, now I might just kind of cancel. We do have Boys and Girls Club that comes on every first, but I can kind of, you know. Yeah. So if we had the first Sunday that's available on From the Heart, you can come back the first Sunday to continue, you know, before your event.
Okay.
Check the calendar and we'll talk, you know. Okay. But Tony, we got to get Mr. Lance hooked up, but can you give us a few notes? Now, it can only be for a few seconds because time goes by fast.
Okay.
Neither one of us.
I was going to sing I've Had My Share.
Oh, okay. Okay.
I've had my share of life's ups and downs, and fate's been kind. The downs have been few. Oh, I guess you could say that I've been lucky. Oh, I guess you could say that it's all because of you. You say if I should ever write my life story, for whatever reason there might be. Between each line of pain and glory, 'cause you're the best thing
that's ever happened to me. You're the best thing ever happened to me.
You're the best thing
that's ever happened to me.
Wow. Now that's something. Now let me tell you, I can sing a little bit too.
Can we hear you?
Oh yeah,
can we hear you?
No, I'm mad at you. No, sometimes I do. I clown around on TV and I'll just, you know, mess around with my voice.
Sing
but
when you sang at Nature's Wet.
I'm not going to do that. I'm going to sing that because it would take up too much time. But you know I can sing a touch because it came from her.
Can I say a little bit more about this? About
yes,
the event?
Sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. September 5th, tickets are $10. Advanced ticket sales only. Let me repeat that. Advance ticket sales only. Call 302-220-6541. 302-220-6541 for your tickets. Bring your own bottle.
Bottle of what, lemonade?
Tea, coffee, orange juice, it's up to you. you may forget what I was going to say. That's pretty much it. Just make sure you get your tickets early, because it's only going to be a limited amount of tickets sold. We want to keep this very small and personal. I don't want to fill this place up with people. I just want it nice and personal.
Yes.
So the people that are coming really want to hear what we have to say.
Now, sir, I'm going to let Mr. Lance go over, but let me tell you something. We're going to do something in the future that's going to be the talents within us.
Okay.
And like I said, I can't sing unless I know God's got me. One of those Sundays is going to be some of the people that have ran through the airways of this love train From the Heart, and I will be one to sing.
Okay.
Now I'll let you determine. We can always say we can do this and we can do that, but I'll be one of the things. Mr. Lance, Tony, a lot of different people will come on. It's going to be nothing but a full hour of the talents within us. Some people will be on, you wouldn't have a clue they could sing, but they're bashful. You know, and they want to do, but it takes a special, you know, yeah.
Do you sing in tune?
Sir, can't she sing in tune? Don't mess with me.
I'm asking you, can you sing in tune?
Oh, can
yeah,
I?
Yeah, she can sing.
Yeah, I would like to believe I could, sir, but I don't want to brag on me. I would like you to judge me for your sound.
Okay.
Okay, and that's going to be something to be looking forward to.
Okay, I look forward to it.
If not, he'll make you go over and over for 20.
Yeah.
But you actually know by a person singing right then and there, they can sing it to you. You can pick it up, can't you?
Yes.
Okay, that's good. Well, then you'll have me to pick up.
Okay.
All right, now, we're going to have final moment, though. I said, Mr. Lance, we're going to ask you to take off your mic to get over for the next couple songs. And we want to ask for anybody that wants to, Tony, last moment thoughts, and Mr., you know, you last moment thoughts.
Go ahead,
okay,
Tom.
And then we don't want to forget Lapa Dance. As Mr., we're going to take a short break. As Mr. Lance goes over, we want to bring Lapa on, the Lapa Dance, because that supports, you know,
okay,
the purpose.
Well, my final thoughts are...
ever since the first time I met you, I knew that you were the one.
Dynamic Mr. Lance Bruce. We only have a second. Tony, 1 second.
1 second. Well, I just wanted to make sure that everybody knows my book is going to be coming out. It's going to be called Simply Beautiful. I hope you'll support me when it's out, and I'll keep Marva informed when the time gets close.
Funk Fest 2015, a musical family reunion, September 5th, Longshoreman's Hall, 200 South Claymont Street in Wilmington. Tickets are $10. Called 302-220-6541. Advanced ticket sales only. Advanced ticket sales only. Walt's catering service will be serving, selling food from the kitchen.
Thank you, viewers, and we'll see you next week. Thank you so much. Have a great day.